Hey PRP, I'm Matt.
And I'm Brandon.
As you all can see, I have a new partner this week. This is the first time that BJ has ever anchored, and I'm so excited that I get to be up here with him for the first time before he graduates.
Thanks, Matt.
Not a problem, buddy.
So let's get to it. There's not too much to cover this week because, well, it's the last week of school. But one of the fellow Ridge News reporters recently took a trip to New York. Let's go to Nynaesha to see how her trip went.
Many students have always wanted to travel but never had the opportunity. What they didn't know was teachers at PRP actually take a handful of students on trips outside of the state. Ms. Webb took me and a few other students to New York this past Derby. We got to see things you only get to watch on TV. We got to stand on top of the Empire State Building and tower over New York, take pictures, and walk through Cherokee Park. We even got to shop on Times Square, as well as the historical things like Immigration Center, Statue of Liberty, and MoMA, Museum of Modern Art. We did so much more. New York is not the only trip. If you like more information on the trips that our school offers, watch the halls for the EF posters. Reporting from Ridge News, I'm Nynaesha. Have a nice summer.
I've always wanted to go to New York, so I'm thinking about taking a little vacation this summer. BJ, I know you've put together your last tech tip, and I really am going to miss those because those are some of my favorite segments. So I guess let's go to you for our last tech tip.
This time last week, Google I/O kicked off in San Francisco, California. At the two-day event, Google made a number of new announcements. First was Android M. M brings a lot of new features, including an update to how app permissions work. When you install an app, Android M will not prompt you with a list of permissions. Instead, when you need to use a feature of the app, it will prompt you then. The dev preview of M is now available for the Nexus 5, 6, 9, and Player. Android Pay is expanded by partnering with mobile providers to pre-install the feature on new devices. To authenticate payments, you can use your fingerprints to verify your identity. Partners include AT&T, T-Mobile, and Verizon. Google is using its Nest acquisition to step into the Internet of Things market by announcing a new OS called Project Brillo. Brillo is derived from Android to provide a low-power wireless solution that is scalable to all types of devices. It's also using its own language called Weave to communicate between the Brillo OS, a device, and the cloud. Google teased a new feature on Android it calls Now on Tap that lets you tap and hold the home button, and Google will bring up information relevant to the content on screen. The new Google Photos app allows you to keep unlimited photos stored in the cloud for free. Additionally, you can sort your photos based on people and places without the need of adding tags.
We can automatically group photos of the same person over time. So say I'm looking for something specific. I remember being caught in a really bad snowstorm about 10 years ago back home. Normally, it would take me forever to find these photos. Instead, I just tap the search box. I'll type snowstorm in Toronto. And instantly, I'm able to find these photos that I'm looking for.
Google Photos has the ability to create videos or collages based on suggestions the app gives according to location and date. It can also auto-create a movie based on recent content as well. Google Photos is now available on Android, iOS, and the web. A couple weeks ago, Matt, Abby, and I put together a segment on Google Cardboard. Google announced that Cardboard will now work with iOS. Google announced Expeditions, which will allow teachers to be able to take their students on virtual field trips to anywhere.
Let's have a look.
You could pick anywhere in the world that you want to go. Where would you want to go?
I would like to go to the moon.
Thailand. Ancient Greece.
India. To Nigeria, my homeland.
One or maybe all of the seven wonders of the world.
When you explore different places, you have the chance to actually learn something new.
You want to be able to show the kids that there's something outside of your community that you could go to and learn from, and that there's other places you can visit.
All right, so let's do our objective, and we'll talk about the lesson for today.
We're going to take a field trip to Verona, Italy, to see the place where Romeo and Juliet lived.
I'm going to take you on this field trip under the water.
Okay, you guys ready? Pick up your devices
and look in your cardboard.
What is that?
Oh, I see a shark.
Whoa! Whoa!
It allowed us to go somewhere we wouldn't normally be able to go.
Are we in China?
This is the Great Wall of China.
We got to see the place itself so we could actually understand what she was talking about.
How long would it take to walk the length of the Great Wall of China?
So much more enriching than just showing them a picture or just having them read about it.
This device can actually make us go to places that we've never been before.
It brings the lesson to you. You have to see it for yourself to believe it.
There's so much other places to see, so you know that it's never gonna end.
Finally, Google announced Jump, a camera rig system that will allow anyone to record VR video. Google also partnered with GoPro to sell a Jump-ready camera rig this year. YouTube will support Jump videos available to try this summer. I want to say thanks to Ms. Dunn for allowing me to start building Ridge News and providing me with experiences I would have never had otherwise. Even though they may say differently, without Michael, Tyler, Matt, and Abby, Ridge News would not be as developed as it is. It's been a pleasure being the lead producer, technical director, and tech reporter. Signing off for the last time, I'm Brandon LeDuc, reporting for Ridge News. I will really miss making them. Last but not least, I put together a highlights piece for all the great times we've had in Ridge News. I hope you all enjoy.
Now I've got
I love watching that piece. You did an awesome job. But that's all for this season of Ridge News. Brandon, I love you, and I'm going to miss you like crazy.
Love you too, Matt.
I hope
so. I'll come back and visit you.
You better. I'm going to hold you to that.
I will.
Have a great summer, PRP.
When I was a boy, I dreamed of a place in the sky, playing in the fields, battling with my shields, bows made out of twine. I wish I could see this world again through those eyes, see the child in me, in my fantasy, never growing old. Will we ever feel young again? Will we ever feel young? We wanna feel young. We wanna feel young.
Thanks, Abby. Let's take a quick look at the upcoming back up.
I didn't put it in there.
That's what BJ said. BJ, you lied to me?
What?
The juniors, they've been working really hard lately.
Slow down. The game is today here at 6 here at PRP. Don't forget to come and support.
And cheer on the male cheerleaders.
Taking a pretty warm weekend with some clouds hanging around for just a little while. And for next week, we're looking at a pretty cloudy week until Thursday. We'll get some nice cloud break and a great sunny day. That's all for this forecast update. Back to you guys. And that's how you guys do it.
I'm Danisha.
And I'm Amadina.
We've been gone for a while, but we're back now. Stop. I didn't know y'all was recording.
We're recording?
Thanks, Dominic.
What?
Oh, we can go. I post quite a bit of things about many topics. What did I just say?
Welcome to this week's edition of Ridge News. I looked it up. Stop. Sorry.
Really?
Awesome.
Well, we finally saw some snow this week, but I have my doubt. All right. Well, can you go back up? Just a little.